What's up, internet? I am Manish from RebellionRider.com. Today, I will show you how to unlock HR user in Oracle Database 21c. So without wasting much of your time, let's start. In previous versions, the sample schemas were placed inside the default pluggable database. But in Oracle Database 21c, we have to download the sample schemas. And you can do that from this GitHub repository.
I will leave the link of this GitHub repo in the description. Anyways, from this Oracle Database 21c sample schema section, click on the source code and download the zip file. We have to extract the content of this zip file. For that, first copy this zip file and then go to your Oracle home. The location that is flashing on your screen is my Oracle home. It could be different in your case.
I will leave the link of the video demonstrating how to find out your Oracle home in just 32 seconds in the description.
Anyways, from Oracle home, go inside the directory named demo. Inside the demo directory, I already have a folder named schemas. If you have one, then it's okay. If you don't, then create one. Inside this schemas folder, paste the sample schemas zip file that we just downloaded. Extract its content. I will move all these content from here to here. That will be much better. Let's delete this file now. Great. Done.
To install and unlock the HR user in Oracle Database 21c, we have to edit the hr_main.sql script. First, let's locate this script.
You can find it inside the folder named Human Resources. Get inside it. Here is the script. Now open it up. Now come to the end of the script. Here you will see that we have some reference link to other script starting with the phrase sub_cwd. We have to change this reference link with the actual location path of the scripts. Let's do that. All these scripts are placed inside same human resources folder. So go inside the folder and copy its path. Done. Now come to the script and change all the reference links with this path. Just make sure all these paths must start with @sign, otherwise the script won't execute. Okay, all the reference paths have been updated. Now replace all these forward slashes with the backward slashes, so that we have one uniform path. Done. Okay, the hr_main.sql script has been modified successfully. Save it and close it.
Before we start installing or unlocking the HR schema, first we need to prepare our database. Let's quickly do that.
Log into your database using sysuser. Right now, I'm connected with the root container using sysuser. Next, we will switch the container from root to pluggable. But first, let's clear the screen. Now, let's switch the container. Here, ORCLPDB is the name of my pluggable database. It could be different in your case. Session altered. Before we perform any action, we need to make sure our pluggable database is open for read-write operations. Let's check. Since the pluggable database is mounted, we need to open it. This statement will open the pluggable database. Pluggable database altered.
As I said that, alter pluggable database DDL will open the pluggable database, but only for a single session.
Oh no.
As soon as you log out from the session, it will close again. The solution to this problem is to save the current state of the pluggable database so that it will stay open across the sessions. And we can save this state like this.
This statement will save the current state of the pluggable database and the PDB will remain open across the sessions. Pluggable database altered.
If you want to know how to save the state of all the pluggable databases just by using single statement, then watch the YouTube shorts I uploaded earlier. Link on your screen and in the description. Anyways, now that we have opened the pluggable database, it's time to execute our hr_main.sql script and unlock the HR user. Let's do that.
Let's first clear the screen. Now execute the script. First write @ followed by the location path of the script and then the name of the script with the extension .sql. Do not execute. Now we have to specify 6 parameters. Let's do that. Give a space and specify the password that you want to set for your HR user. I will set the password to HR. Again, give a space and specify the name of the default table space for the HR user. In my case, it will be users. Again, give a space and specify the name of the temporary table space. For me, it will be temp. The fourth parameter will be the password of your sys user. In my case, the password for my sys user is Oracle. Fifth parameter will be the path for the logs. I will be saving my logs in the log directory that I have already created inside the demo folder. You can save your logs any way you want. Just make sure to end the path with the forward slash. The sixth parameter is connect string. It is a string formed by adding hostname followed by colon and then the port number followed by forward slash and then the service name for the pluggable database into which you want to place your HR user. You can get all this information from your tnsnames.aura file. In my case, this connect string will look something like this. Now we are all set to execute our script. Let's do that. User HR installed and unlocked successfully.
That's how we unlock HR user in Oracle Database 21c. Hope you enjoyed watching this video. If so, then give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Also, press the bell icon to get notified. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon. Till then, take care. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.